Then you'd spend ages finessing the scale shape. So yeah, it was time to zoom.
Left the business in 2001, and everything was mainly with clipboards. And couldn't make their mind at what they wanted.
I was reviewing Potty Pigeon last night.
Okay.
With the world's first shit 'em up. So I was quite inspired.
This introduced an idea called virtual theatre, where you'd actually give commands to characters. So you had a sidekick called Rat Pouch, and you could tell Rat Pouch to go to any location that you know, and then pick up any objects that you'd seen. And it kind of introduced the idea of a much more, well, immersion gameplay.
Hey everybody, Zach from the film here. How's it going? I know it's time for a much needed update on the film. Well, we've got a lot of great stuff to talk about. The news is good. The film is almost finished. And I wanted to give you a detailed idea of where we're at so you can know what all we've done and what we have left to do to get the film out. The film will be out this year. We've got all the story content in. So the story is edited. We use the interviews that we shot all over the country in several states and a few places in Europe. And we accumulated upwards of 50 interviews from some of the most interesting and important people in the Amiga scene and in the Amiga's history. All of the 3D models that we need for the animation in the film have all been created. And we've been animating those and inserting them as B-roll. Big special thanks to my friend Paul, who spent several months last year, mainly over the summer and fall, working to create these models, which really bring the film to life in terms of the visuals. I can't wait to show you the final renders, and those will be cooking soon. Last summer, I got together with my pal Bill Winters, and we took all of the different Amigas that we had into a studio and really got some great shots of these. These are being inserted to the film now, all the different Amiga models. And I just want to say big thanks again to Bill Winters for helping me with that. They look really great. And yeah, here's an example of what some of these look like. I think they're really cool and they fit well with the overall look that we're going for. We spent many months collecting all of the different still images that we could get from different Amiga magazines, going way back into the beginning, scanning those, sorting them, and inserting them into the film. And right now on the screen, you can see a few of these. We really got stuff from all over the world, really great high quality images. And these serve as the B-roll, like I've been talking about, which help illustrate what the people in the film are speaking to. We've got great music from several different composers made especially for the film. And just kind of shuffle through a few of these right now. Really great tracks. We're going for kind of a nostalgic 80s sound. Some ambient music, some music that's kind of reminiscent of what the Amiga used to produce, as well as a track or two that was actually created on the Amiga. So one of the main points I want to drive home is the fact that, you know, the film doesn't just consist of a bunch of guys talking about the Amiga. They talk about the Amiga, but we really also show you what the Amiga was like in a visual way using the animation. Lots of great archival footage that we've inserted, and just tons of visuals to really help people understand like what the Amiga was, how awesome it was, rather than just having people talk about it. So obviously that takes quite a long time, and the bulk of the time that I've spent has been working on that, trying to bring the film to life visually, and it's totally working.
I mean, dollar for dollar, nothing can even come close to the Amiga 3000. By the way, how are we coming on the Liquid Scrubbo presentations?
I beg your pardon?
So, what's next? Well, what's next is we've got a pretty hard deadline here for a meeting that we have in a couple months with a gentleman who has offered to help us in terms of distribution of the film. He has some pretty good contacts, and I think he'll be able to help us get the film out there in a big way. So, over the next few weeks, we're hustling, polishing the film up as much as we can for a big presentation. And after that, I hope to be able to give you more exact dates of when we're going to release the film. But like I said, it'll be out this year, and Kickstarter people, you'll have your copy as soon as it's finished. Most importantly, thank you. I know it's excruciating to wait, you know, for this film to come out. I know I'm as excited as you are to see it, probably more so. I can't tell you how much time I've spent on this thing, but it's all worth it. It looks really great. It's absolutely the coolest thing I've ever done, and it's gonna knock your socks off when it comes out, no doubt about it. Because it's really cool. It's great. It's got everything. It's got all the people. It's got all the visuals. It's gonna make you laugh. It's gonna make you cry. And we're almost finished, so just thanks for hanging in with me. And stay tuned for more updates. going to be picking up the number of updates for Kickstarter and the other social media as we go. We're also launching a new website in the next couple days. Keep your eyes out for that. And thanks a lot for watching.
Hi, I'm Holly. This is my dad, Dave Lowe, also known as Uncle Art. He's a musician and a programmer and did the music for lots of games in the 80s and 90s, over 70 game titles, including some big ones like Elite, Star Gliders, Street Fighter 2, Carrier Command, IK Plus, blah, 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 blah.
And this is my daughter, Holly, who is a professional musician as well, and she has played all over the world, really, and she now works at Uncle Art with me. And it was her idea, really, to get on Kickstarter and redo some of these original pieces.
Yeah, basically we see a lot of requests for wanting remakes of the original pieces that you did, because they're too good, really, to not remake them.
So the Kickstarter project is a CD with remakes of the best titles. We're going to remake them using electronic stuff and real instruments with real musicians, because we are, you know, both live musicians. Yeah, and we want to really redo it the way it could be done in those days if we'd had, you know, the technology that could deal with it.
Yeah, and then we're going to do your Frontier, the Elite Frontier.
The main theme and the second theme that I wrote, we're going to do them basically at Abbey Road with a real orchestra.
It's going to sound amazing. But we can only do this, obviously...
Yeah, with your support.
We really want to do it, but we really need... We only can do it if you guys want it, so please...
Kickstarter gives us the opportunity to find out whether you do want it. And if you do, we'll do it. It will be great.
Yeah. So, yeah, we've made a little teaser for you. This is this piece of music that you're going to hear has got some of, Star Glider, Carrier Command, Afterburner, Elite in it as well. Just a bit of a fusion together of all of those pieces, give you an idea of what we're sort of talking about with those remakes, and I really hope you like it.
Yeah,
thanks for watching the video. Cheers.
And enjoy.
What will you do with the Amiga computer?
Atari versus Amiga, there was no contest.
Preemptive, priority-based operating system in a game machine.
You want one word?
An Amiga?
Right on.
I wanted something that could be expanded into a real computer.
It was way ahead of its time. Scroll bars and bouncing balls.
The hardware on the Amiga was pretty incredible stuff, very flexible.
The Amiga was the perfect environment for making original games.
Kids in a candy shop, we suddenly found we could do things.
The idea of creating a world that you could explore that didn't exist anywhere but in the computer was incredibly compelling.
Transition from 8-bit to 16-bit was troublesome.
If you didn't keep up with it, you got very quickly left behind.
We realised either we evolve or die.
Days of programming things entirely by yourself and drawing the graphics were gone.
The industry was growing, so it was like trying to stay on the top of a pile.
Now these games also had to be artistically impressive.
Wonderful music, moving away from bleeps and trying to create a bit of drama and scale and spectacle that no one had really seen in a game.
It was such a big seller at the time. And there's so much reverence for Matthew Smith's work since. I think we all realize that something special was happening. And to have that perspective and to look back and see just how huge it was, I think that's when you realize, you know what, I did take part in something important. And I'm pleased I did that.